Welcome to Reality Creative Video. I'm Hermes, and today I want to talk to you about creating the best colloidal gold you can possibly get. Give you some tips and tricks on it. Because if you've started to create your own colloidal gold, you might have found some inconsistencies. I mean, you were really excited when you first did it, and then after you've cooked several batches, you found out that, they're not all exactly the same. How do I get my ruby red colloidal gold? It seems to vary. So first, let's share some tips. All right, I'm getting ready to cook a batch of colloidal gold. Now, what I like to do is I preheat the water in the microwave to for 6 minutes. This is 500 milliliters of water, and then I add all of our chemicals, which brings it up to 550 milliliters of water. And then I will put it in the microwave. Now, refer back on the how to make colloidal gold video for all the little intricacies of that I'm bypassing really fast here. So then I'll put it in the microwave over there and heat it for 6 minutes. That gets me to about between 80 and 90 degrees C. Then I toss it on my heater here. And I let the heated stirrer, bring it up the rest of the way. So one of the things I do is I do not start the process until it hits 90 degrees C, which is just hit now. And the reason I do that is because your gold process will be fairly consistent if you're consistent with all of the little stuff with it. And that means like, the space between the anode and the cathode is the consistent. The water temperature is consistent. Actually, your chemicals that you put in there should be consistent. The thing that I also like to increase the efficiency of the process is add 10 milliliters of colloidal gold that I've already made. Now, if they haven't made colloidal gold, you won't have that. But once you make colloidal gold, you will have the extra 10 milliliters, and you pour that in your mix in addition to the chemicals. And that will help bind it a lot faster. Now, I've gotten this process down to 20 minutes. In 20 minutes, I will use 7 milligrams of material of gold off of my gold anode, a cathode here, and that will give me between 12 and 14 parts per million perfect ruby red. And that's keeping everything consistent. Now, the only thing that could change with your amount of time is the amount of gold you have. The more surface area you have in contact with the liquid, the faster your gold is going to cook. So I'm going to turn this on right now. I'm going to set my timer here to start counting for 20 minutes. And I will keep an eye on that. Usually if I get busy, I will set a timer in my watch here to remind me to stop the process in 20 minutes. Because the danger that you have here is colloidal gold orange. If you overcook colloidal gold, it will go orange. And I have a video showing this. I didn't plan to make this video. It was back in the early days when I was doing colloidal gold. I didn't understand and I forgot and left the process. And I happened to put the time-lapse camera on it. So I'm going to show you a video of what happens if you let your gold go too far. You will see in this video that it starts out very nice becoming a ruby red and quickly degenerates into colloidal orange. I'm not saying colloidal orange is bad for you. I use the colloidal orange. It's just that it is a tremendous amount of gold that you are wasting, and your body cannot use any more of it. So even though it might be a more highly concentrated version of gold, it's the ruby red gold that does all of the magic in your body. So you really don't want to go orange because you're using probably twice or three times the amount of gold. And gold is an expensive commodity, so we don't want to use twice or three times the amount of gold. And personally, I've overcooked. I've never had... I haven't overcooked gold to the point where you saw on that video since that video. But I've cooked gold to the orange state. And I've talked about the orange state of gold and how the subtle difference in how it looks in the beakers. And, you know, when it's just starting to turn orange. So what I found is, besides the fact that you've probably wasted 3 or 4 more milligrams of gold than you needed to, I don't personally see any health benefit to orange. In fact, I find it is less effective. If you're looking for the limitless, that I call it, you know, where your brain is firing on all thrusters, the colloidal orange does not seem to give me the limitless. It's just that it's that colloidal gold, ruby red colloidal gold, that gives the limitless thing. But you get the other benefits from gold, the anti-inflammatory nature of gold and the improved DNA and things like that, that gold is also responsible for. I'll put a list up here of the benefits of gold offhand. I'll have to search, but that's basically why, you know, my reason for taking the gold is the mental clarity and even the dream recall and stuff like that is nice in gold. And gold's a good anti-inflammatory, which is good. It can help reduce a little pain relief. I can't say it's terrific at pain relief, but the anti-inflammatory nature of gold does help reduce pain relief. As you can see, we're into 3 minutes and 25 seconds, and we already got ourselves a nice light-tinted gold there, pinkish, rose-colored stuff there, which will continue to develop and get darker. I've timed the process, so I stop it at 20 minutes. Now, if you're not sure and you don't want to overcook your colloidal gold, all right, so let's say you don't know exactly how long it's going to take for you to cook gold, I would wait until you start to see this get a little bit darker than what you got here. And then I would turn the process off. And you're going to find something weird going on. This is going to continue to develop and get darker. All right. Now, a lot of times when I overcooked gold, it was because I brought my gold to looking like this. All right. This is ruby red colloidal gold. This is what it's supposed to look like. And what had happened is the gold continues to cook after you turn off the electrolysis process. So you can bring it to this ruby red color, and then you turn off the electrolysis process, but it's possible you've already overcooked it, and it's going to continue to get darker and darker and start to turn yellow, orange. So what I did in order to get my 20-minute figure down was I would let it get a little bit darker like this, and then I would turn off the power. I'd leave it for 10 minutes and see what color it finally stabilized on. And then, having a 3-digit scale, I would measure the weight of my gold rod. Now, my gold rod is twisted gold. In order to get the extra thickness, I've twisted the gold rod together. And you can do that. You can take like 2 or 3 strands of 22-gauge gold wire and twist them together to make them thicker. I do that because it cooks faster. Like I said, the more surface area you have, the thicker it cooks. And it also enables me to twist the fine gold wires so that they don't break apart when they get too thin. They stay all twisted nice together in this bundle, and then I can cook away pretty much the whole entire thin 22 gauge rods, where normally they would get so thin they would just break apart and you'd be wasting all of this gold that can't hold itself together because there's not enough material. Well, if you twist it tightly together, that isn't going to happen. The twists from your outer pieces of gold are going to keep the inner pieces of gold from falling apart, and they will actually cook and go into the substance. So naturally, you have to keep, when your outer pieces start getting thin, you have to take another piece of 22 or whatever 24 gauge gold wire and twist that on top of your existing gold. That's if you're using gold rods and you want to get the most out of it. If you're using a gold coin, well, then you have a lot of surface area in there already. A gold coin is another way you can go with using gold, creating colloidal gold. It has to be 24K bullion colloidal gold, a gold coin in order to give you the ruby red colloidal gold. So, and naturally, you just want to put half the coin in the liquid. You don't want the alligator clip. You do not want the alligator clip going into the solution, or you're going to be cooking whatever material this your alligator clip is made out of. So, and you can rotate the coin around. You know, you cook half the coin, then rotate it. The next time you cook gold and cook the second half of the coin, and that'll keep your coin even. For those of you using gold bullion. So as you can see, we're into 8 minutes now, and we're definitely getting close to this color. Now I know it's going to take 20 minutes, but had I not been certain that it was going to take 20 minutes, I would let it get to this color, and I would shut this off. Like I said, wait 5 minutes, weigh my rod. If you got a 3-digit scale, weigh the rod to see how much material you've actually used. And your goal is 7 grams, 6 or 7 milligrams of gold material to make ruby red. You might get away with 8 milligrams of material, which give you a little darker ruby red, but you're getting awfully close to, you know, orange territory when you're getting close to the 8 milligrams. And also keep in mind, if you're using twisted gold wire, you have to wait for the water to dry out in between the twisted gold wire before you're going to get a accurate weight measurement. It will always weigh heavier with the water in between the twisted gold wire to dry up before you can get accurate measurement. If you're just using a solid piece of 22 gauge gold, then you don't have to worry about that. Just wipe it off, do your measurement, and you'll know where you stand there. Now, of course, if you're using a 22-gauge gold wire or 24-gauge gold wire, it may take longer than the 20 minutes here. But when I was, you know, from what I recall, when I was making colloidal gold and I only had my first 22-gauge gold wire, I remember it taking about 34 minutes, 35 minutes. So not a whole lot longer than the 20 minutes. So keep that in mind when you're cooking your colloidal gold. And that's it. That is the tips and tricks that I have about producing a perfect ruby red colloidal gold every time. I'm Hermes. This is Reality Creative Video, and I will talk to you again soon.